In this screencast, we'll look at a two-component system which undergoes a phase change and calculate the amount of heat it takes to reach a final temperature. So we have 12 moles per minute, equimolar, so that means both n-pentane and n-hexane, 6 moles per minute. Temperature is 20 degrees C, fed continuously at some P, which is not stated, and the mixture is heated to 65 degrees C. So we know that 30% of the pentane in the feed is vaporized, and 40% of the vapor stream is pentane, and now we want to know how much heat must be transferred to the mixture per minute. So let's start by drawing the picture. So note we have four unknowns and two species balances. So we're going to need two extra pieces of information in order to solve that. And we have it right here and here. So let's start with the first one. So 30%, 0.3, of the pentane in the feed, which is 6 moles, and remember we're doing this per minute, is vaporized. So that's going to be equal to the number of moles of vapor that's pentane, and that's equal to 1.8 moles. The second thing that we're given is that 40% of the vapor stream is pentane, so 0.4 of the vapor stream is pentane, and we know that that's equal to 1.8 moles. Therefore, we know that the vapor stream is equal to 4.5 moles. So there are a number of ways you can do this to figure out the rest of it, but one of the things that you know is if 1.8 moles of the pentane is vaporized, then the rest of it is got to be in the liquid stream, and that's equal to 4.2 moles. Now, we know that the liquid stream here has got to equal 12 minus 4.5, and so that's equal to 7.5 moles. And we know that 4.2 moles of it is pentane, so the number of moles of liquid that are hexane is equal to 3.3 moles. So let's make sure we have this. So we have our NVP, our NLP, our NLH, and now all we have to do is figure out the number of moles of vapor that are hexane. And we can do that just using a hexane balance. So we know that 6 moles come in, and we know that in the liquid stream it's 3.3 moles. Therefore, there are 2.7 moles of hexane in the vapor stream. So next we'll construct an enthalpy table and put in what we know. So what's our next step? We need to choose our reference state. So in a reference state, you have to determine what your phase, your temperature, and your pressure are going to be. And the significance of a reference state is that this is where the enthalpy is going to be zero. So the first thing that I look at when I'm setting a reference stage is the phase. And we have 6 streams here, 4 of which are liquid. So I choose that for my reference phase. And why? Because going from our reference phase to our final phase doesn't require a phase change for those streams. So what we're going to say is pentane and hexane that are liquid. Next, we need the temperature, and either of the temperatures would be fine. However, I generally choose the incoming temperature. So our temperature that's incoming, if we take a look, is equal to 20 degrees C. And why? Well, if you calculate your Q, this is equal to the sum of the enthalpies out minus that of the enthalpies in. And if you choose your incoming temperature as your reference, these will all go to zero. And finally, for our reference pressure, we're just going to use the pressure of the system. So here's our references, and let's put in what we know based on this references, and that's going to be that H1 is going to be equal to zero, and that H2 is going to be equal to zero. So because the vapor enthalpies involve phase change, we need to find the boiling points and the heat of vaporizations for both pentane and hexane. So let's put them in right now. In addition, because we're going to need to find sensible heat or heat caused by a temperature change, we're going to need the heat capacities of both the liquid and the vapor for both pentane and hexane. So let's calculate our enthalpies. Again, H1 and H2 are zero. And we'll start with the liquid enthalpy since our reference state is liquid, and we'll therefore only need to calculate the sensible heats. And that's for H3 and H4. So how do we get that sensible heat? Well, our H hat is equal to the integral from our T reference to our T final C sub P dT. Now, since each one of our heat capacities is one term, this ends up being that it's equal to our C sub P, and then that's delta T. So let's calculate the two of them. Note that we use the heat capacities of the liquid because H3 and H4 are liquid enthalpies, and 65 degrees C, our final temperature, is what that substance ends up at when it leaves the unit, and 20 degrees C is our reference. So now we have H3 and H4. However, the next two enthalpies, H5 and H6, involve phase change, so we have to start at the reference state, calculate the sensible heat to the boiling point, add the heat of vaporization, and then find the sensible heat from the boiling point to the final point. So let's write that out in terms of our equation. So note this equation can be used for both H5 and H6, the pentane and hexane vapor. The only things that will change are the boiling points, the C sub P's, and the H of vaporization. So why can we do this? Well, enthalpy is a state function, therefore it depends only on the final minus the initial state. The initial state is the reference state, and the final state is a vapor at 65 degrees C. So let's start with pentane. And if we go back here, that's our H5. So we'll write it out according to this equation. So our H5 is, again, because this is a single term heat capacity, we can pull it out of the integral. So that's equal to our 0.1544. So that's the heat capacity of the liquid kilojoules per mole. And now this first delta T is the difference between the boiling temperature of pentane and the reference temperature. So now our pentane is a liquid at the boiling point. And so we want to make it a vapor, and by doing that, we add the heat of vaporization, 25.77 kilojoules per mole. And so now our pentane is a vapor at the boiling point. And what we need it at, a vapor at 65 degrees C. So in order to do that, we're going to have to add our sensible heat. And careful, we need to use the C sub P of the vapor because the pentane is a vapor at this point. And our delta T is our final temperature, 65 degrees C minus the boiling point, 36.07. And that's going to be equal to 31.6 kilojoules per mole. And so now we're going to do the same thing for the hexane. Note we used the exact same approach as we did for H5. The only things that are different are the C sub P's, the boiling points, and the heat of vaporization. So now let's look at our table. So we use the values in this table to find our final Q. Note, because of our reference state, our enthalpies coming in are zero, so our Q is going to be equal to the summation of our enthalpies coming out, which is going to be the summation of our number of moles of whatever species times the specific enthalpy of the species. So here now it's just a matter of using the values in our table. So we'll just start from the first row. So that's 4.2 moles times 7.0 kilojoules per mole. So that's the liquid pentane plus now our 3.3 moles times its specific enthalpy, which is 9.6 kilojoules per mole. We add to that our vapor pentane, so that's 1.8. And notice now, because of the latent heat or heat of vaporization that's been added, this number is a lot larger. So that's 31.6 kilojoules per mole. And finally, we add the enthalpy of the hexane vapor, which is 2.7 moles times 38.8 kilojoules per mole. So the amount of heat that it's going to take for pentane and hexane liquid at 20 degrees C and a pressure of P0 to 65 degrees C in both the liquid and the vapor form is equal to 223 kilojoules.